come in, and that's Mr. Lee, Mr. Lai, and Miss Wang over there. We also have a model to put on slides next time. And I also want to encourage our teacher members here to think of possible topics for next year's Education Summit. Right, because without the support from the community, I'm afraid this summit will not continue in that sense. Right? We need to sustain it, and we actually need your support. So as you see through today's proceedings, try to think of some topics that you might want to present next year, and then we keep this going. Okay? I'm also very grateful to Dr. Lim for initiating the first local Python conference, because Python conference is usually held internationally, right? And we need a champion here to say, hey, we must have a local conference, because we cannot be sending so many people overseas for the overseas conference. So I'm very grateful to Dr. Liu for initiating this 6 years ago. And ever since then, we have always been sending our students to support the conference, for the conference, to learn at the conference. Okay? And this year, I'm also very happy that we had this Education Summit. That's why I agreed to come and give a talk on the computing landscape in our schools. Okay? So I was looking at some of the expectations from the participants on what they would like to find out from this Education Summit. And I have these two questions which I classify as, what's the importance of computing? What do we want to study computing? How does it move the person or prepare the person for a career? The computing in our schools currently, because of our policy, is broad-based. So we are not like New Zealand where we, you know, prepare the students and then they can choose which area they want to go to and get a work skills certification. So we are not like New Zealand in that sense. We are very broad-based. And so at the secondary school, at the JC, it is perhaps too early to prepare that. And we are also not like the European countries, although we are not classified as an applied learning subject. We are not like the European countries where it is really applied learning, where they have apprenticeship and people are actually being prepared for a career. We are not like that as well, although we are an applied learning subject, right? So our definition of applied learning is to say that, well, we are not the geeks that are just tied to the chair. We look at real life applications. So what you are learning in computing has real life applications, so you can apply what you learn, right? So I have this data from the US website to show you, future parents, when you're thinking of whether you should allow your children to study computing, what are some of the jobs that we want? There are some data from IBA, but I'm not in a position to share that, right? So I use the US source, which is on the website. So you'll notice that in the future, from 2008 to 2018, right, computing jobs are in demand, 71%. Okay? And out of these computing jobs, you will see that software engineering is important, and so that means programming as well. Computer networking, and we also need computer support staff. We need database admin people, and we also need systems analysis. Okay? Now, the IDA data has a different set of classification. And sometimes when you look at the IDA data, it doesn't surface that these are the important areas. Right? So, it depends on the country, it depends on the officers who is doing the classification. Sometimes you will have to interpret the data carefully in that sense. Right, so basically these are also three questions that participants expect to learn from this Education Summit. And so they form my agenda for this presentation. I will talk about the formal and informal curriculum that we have in Singapore. In our MOE mainstream schools, I will not be able to talk about the private schools or some certain IP schools that do not follow our programs. Okay? So I will just talk about our mainstream schools. What's the vision of the future of computing? Is there a future? Our teachers are also very worried that they will be out of jobs if they teach computing, right? Because there's no future. So we need to assure our teachers that there is a future. And what are the current practices and future directions? So currently in Singapore, computer education, okay, is available in these three categories. I classify them under curriculum subjects, which is the formal curriculum, enrichment programs, and then co-curriculum. Okay? Co-curricular, we have the co-curricular activity, the CCA, which is the Infocom Club or the Topics Club. We have the Applied Learning Program, okay? And we have Cyber Wellness, which is a talk to students as part of our CCE, Character and Citizenship Education. So under Cyber Wellness, students actually learn about Internet of Things, sort of, and the dangers of the Internet. Right, and they learn how to cope with cyberbullying, they learn about language to be used on the web, on Internet, and ethical, and things like that. Okay? So I will focus on first the curriculum subjects. We have three subjects that have been offered in Singapore for a very, very long time. But as usual, it will come as a surprise to some people that hey, I didn't know that this is being offered. I would have taken it up if I knew, right? So we have at A level an elective subject called H2 Computing. So it is a two-year course, elective meaning that it's not one of those subjects that are designated as you have to take it, right? So those subjects that is designated as you have to take it will be the mother tongue languages. General paper, we have gone through the system. Okay? So ours is an elective subject and the students opt into it. So we have at A levels the H2 Computing and they will sit for the Cambridge exams 2 years later. Okay, so JC1, JC2. And then for the O-level students, we have a subject called Computer Studies and the target audience will be those in our Express stream and normal academic streams. So these are students who are of the higher ability range, mid to higher ability. Okay? So we have streamed them into three streams, the Express, the normal academic, and the normal technical. So for the higher ability students, we encourage them to do O-level subjects and we have one called Computer Studies. So for the lower ability students, okay, we have a normal problem as the world, a declining enrollment. And so right now at this point of time, we only have three schools offering the subject and they are Pioneer JC, Dalman High, and Hwa Chong Institution. Right? Next year, we will have one more school and National Junior College will reopen its doors. There are many, many reasons for the decline, one of which will be teachers who are retiring, teachers who doesn't join the profession because CS grads have a better pay outside. So when we do not have CS grads joining us as a, you know, the teaching profession, then we cannot start the subject. Okay? So there are a lot of reasons. So at the national level, right, in the early years, I think the assessment also played a very important role in attracting students, right? So we have moved from various assessment modes to the present situation where we have moved from coursework to a practical paper. So sitting for a practical exam can also be very daunting and students will also weigh their chances and decide whether they should go for it. Right, but it is part of also cultivating the resilience in our students that they must have that gumbo spirit as well. Right. So the main programming language used so far has been C++, but then from 2013 onwards, we have put Python into the curriculum. So our JC students are now starting to program in Python. So if you have any questions, maybe later on you can ask me or you can also stop me. Right, this is the O-level Computer Studies candidature. You must be wondering, hey, I didn't know about this subject because it was actually started after you left school in 2007. Okay, in 2007, when Minister Taman was our minister, he was promoting applied learning. So we introduced O-level Computer Studies, right? The first year we had a very low intake and then subsequently more and more people come in and then later on you see less and less. So again, there are a lot of reasons and factors. Right? Actually, you can write a few research papers on this, but embargo cannot show to the public. Okay? So then I will not go into those factors. But you look at the assessment, because assessment is always one factor as well. Okay? So assessment-wise, we have been doing coursework, okay? And the coursework is done, the students create a database system,
using Microsoft Access, and it's done over 14 weeks. But moving forward, from 2017 onwards, we will be repackaging, we will introduce a new subject, O-level computing, and the assessment mode is likely to be a practical paper. Okay. So right now, we have 14 schools offering O-level computer studies. Right, so that's why the students also say, if I do at O-level, I have no JCs to go to. My zone has no JC. So we also need to encourage more JCs to open up so that these secondary school students have a place to go to that's nearer to their home. Right? So in 2017, there will be 22 schools. That means currently a few more schools have indicated interest that they will offer the subject in 2017 to their Sec 3 students. Okay? So we hope to encourage more people and grow the enrollment. For A-level applications, we have no problem because it's a compulsory subject. So every year we have 5,000 more students. So Sec 1, the level will be 5,435 schools. Right? At least 40 students in each school. Some school has got 2 classes. So we have 5,000 plus students every year. And this subject was started in 1994, so it has also a very long history. Okay? In the early years, we trained our students to be end user of the system, so they will learn how to use all the Microsoft Office suite. And then in 2007, right, we start to get them into creating something and not just be mere end users and just click buttons all the time, right? So we moved them into creating something of their own, to be creative. So we introduced in the end-level coursework, we taught students, and this is an option. The school choose one of the three. They can either choose to teach their student web page design, or they can teach their student to design a simple database, 1 or 2 files only, okay? And they can also choose to teach their student how to model and design a product. So they can look at the product and then they try to use a computer software to model and design their product. Then in 2012, we moved them towards programming. Some computer science element was introduced into the syllabus because although these are lower ability students, they are classified as lower ability, they may not really be lower ability, right? Okay? So we find that yes, it's possible to teach computer science concepts to these students. So we start to introduce a school-based coursework involving the creation of animation, game-making using the Scratch software. Okay? And annually, we have a competition to recognize and to showcase the students' work. So we will ask the schools to send their best piece, their best coursework piece for animation, their best coursework piece for game, and then we will do the shortlisting, all the judging and all that back end. And after that, we have a ceremony where we recognize and reward the students and showcase their work. So we have been doing this annually since 2012. So this year, we will continue to do it. So any questions? If not, I'll move on to the enrichment program. Okay. So for enrichment program, schools can do it ad hoc. That means they can put it during in their curriculum timetable or specially arranged slots like post-exam activity or every Wednesday stay back for 2 hours with the parents' permission. They conduct the enrichment program. Okay? And they will do it on the whole cohort level. So in the past, it used to be a very mini ICT where we do video editing, we do flash animation. But in 2013, we get approval from our senior management to roll out a Code for Fun program. So we piloted it in 2014. And then this was in a collaboration with IDA. Okay? So in 2014, we partnered IDA. We rolled out Code for Fun using Scratch. We rolled it out to the upper primary and lower sec students. We teach them animation, we teach them games. And then with funding support from IDA, some hardware was introduced. Right? So to date, 16 secondary schools and 8 primary schools have participated. Right? So they learned to use Scratch P4, P5, Sec 1, Sec 2. But some schools went ahead to even teach their P6 by collapsing the 4 and 5 materials and then giving the kit to the P6 as a post-exam activity. Right?
So with funding from IDA and support from IDA, schools were able to teach students some hardware-related programs. Okay? These hardware are compatible with the Scratch. So for the upper primary, they either chose to do the Lego redo set, where they use Scratch to program these pieces to either lift an object or to turn a wheel or something like that, or they program the Moway robot to either follow a light source, follow a path, or avoid obstacles using Scratch, because these are compatible with Scratch. And at the upper secondary level, they will use the Arduino board or the Raspberry Pi to program. Okay? So they will do the blinking LED and things like that. Right? So our basic Scratch program to teach them the coding, animation and game takes 10 hours. And the school can move on with funding support from IDA to do another 10 hours with hardware. And this continues into this year, from 2014 to 2015. Right? So IDA will fund the school on a varying percentage basis and then provide the expertise to teach these programs. So this is the future of computing in our schools. Okay? We will continue to have our Hope for Fun, the enrichment program. We will continue to have our O and A level subject. A level will always be there. This is a compulsory subject. So our elective subjects will still be there. And our plan is as follows, right? In 2014 to 2015, the Hope for Fun programs will be taught by teachers and IDA vendors. Okay? But we want to grow our school capacity. Right? So we hope that from 2016 onwards, the program will be taught by teachers, and we want to reach out to at least 50% of the schools. 2021 and beyond, the program should be available in all the schools. That means we would like to get at least a teacher there who can teach the Code for Fun to the students, whether it is to a whole cohort level, that means all the P4, P5 classes, or students who opt in. Okay. For O-level computing subject, right now we have 14 schools, right? So as from 2017, 22 schools will sign on. So in the years ahead, up to 2020, we hope to get more than 20 schools. And beyond that, we hope to have more than 28 schools. Okay. And for computing, we have 3 schools now. We hope to reach a target of 8 schools from 2016 to 2020, and then beyond that, more than 8 schools and hopefully all the JCs can come back, like what we used to have in the early 1980s. Okay. So in terms of support, right, how do we get the teachers to come on board? So we have 3 areas of training, right? Conversion course for teachers who are interested to teach the subject but may not have the content knowledge and skills. So they can opt to come for training and then teach the subject. We will continue to have in-service workshops to upgrade existing teachers, okay? To bring them up to date with developments and so on. And we are looking into a discussion with NIE to start pre-service training. But again, this is a chicken and egg thing, because if nobody come and apply to teach and be a teacher, there's nobody for them to train. Right, so this is quite a delicate balance to be made there. We are also creating a student learning space to support the teaching of the subject and various other subjects as well. We will be creating online resources to help teachers in teaching the subject and and for students as well to learn the subject. Textbooks and workbooks are also being done, and we also have various e-learning portals, some local, some overseas. Okay. Then going forward, I just want to make another advertisement, and that is Google and IDA, for IDA, is going to give out a Computer Teacher Award starting from this year. So we actually have sent out, we have blast the information, and application will close on the 3rd of July. To nominate teachers, it can be a self-nomination as well, to apply for the Computing Teacher Award, Computer Science Teacher Award. Okay, so this is sponsored by Google. So we have various industry support in that sense to recognize the efforts of our teacher and to also, you know, encourage people to teach computing in that sense. Okay. Do you have any questions?
That's the end. I can take some questions if you have any.
Maybe one practical question.
Yes.
For the programs like Scratch, and do you encourage schools to roll out their own, or you just encourage them to use the existing platform, which is directed at?
Oh, okay. They will use the software from MIT, but the lesson packages are from MOE for the students. Is that what you mean?
The technical platform, do the school roll out their own Scratch server, because now it can be online?
We use the offline version.
You use the desktop.
The desktop version, yes. So we use the desktop version of the software from MIT, and we design the lesson packages for the schools. But going forward, right, because the pilot is new, and all the P4, P5 are learning Scratch, Sec 1, Sec 2 learning Scratch. But going forward, when the primary school students go to the secondary schools, we cannot be teaching them Scratch and Sec 1, Sec 2, because they'll find that they have already learned enough. So we may move into Python programming in the years ahead to introduce a simple Python programming to our Sec 1, Sec 2 students, so that there is this foundation and they will be more confident to take up O-level studies and beyond. Because students and even adults will hesitate because it's a new domain. Yeah? So that will be the language we will be using. But I'm not very sure whether it will be from 2021 that we can introduce Python, or somewhere in 2017, 18 we can introduce already.
Sorry,
could
that be a revamp
for that? We have revamped, so to speak. That's why we have redesigned a new O-level computing subject. So that's why we call it O-level computing and not computer studies. And that new syllabus will be implemented in 2017. And that one has got programming, and the students will program in Python. The current O-level computer studies, no programming, although they learn algorithms. So it has so far been redesigned.
Computer science part, which means teaching them the basics, syntax and things like this, or you also try to integrate it with other subjects using Scratch, not to teach computing, but teaching mathematics, or using it as a kind of simple simulation.
Okay. I think for enrichment programs, we are free to use Scratch to teach them examples of other domains like math, music, or art. But for the disciplines, we really focus on computer science, but the percentage may vary. For example, for our normal technical students, it's something like 80% still ICT and 20% computer science. I mean, these are just rough figures. So the normal technical students will still learn how to use Word, Excel, and all this, which is purely ICT, but they still program animation and game using Scratch. That's a bit like computer science. And they also learn about devices and things like that. So there's some element, but it's a lower percentage. Then this percentage increased for the O-level students. So the O-level subject or the discipline will be more weighting on the computer science concepts, but the students will still learn some Excel functions and things like that. Okay? And then for A-level, it's purely all computer science, and we assume the students know how to type a Word document already. So there are varying percentages of these components.
Sorry,
yes?
For the whole year, I think there are I've advised 150, 60 secondary schools. So you mentioned that 40, 20, just comment like how do these schools come on board and how do you get more schools to come on board?
Okay. In the initial years, when the students, the 14 schools came on board the O-level computer studies, there was a criteria that the teachers must attend an assessor course from Cambridge. So what the exam squad has done is they fly an examiner down to conduct the course and to assess the teacher to be ready to conduct the coursework. If the teacher is assessed as not ready, then the school cannot offer the subject. So in the early years, we only had 14 schools coming on board.
And of course, the cost of paying for this is quite high, so many schools are so-called deterred from taking up the subject. Because if, let's say, five schools want to take up the subject, the five schools will have to pay for this assessor to come over. So it could be like a five-digit figure divided by five schools. So per head count is quite expensive. So in a way, schools get deterred and they decided that they do not want to offer that. So moving forward, right, to encourage more schools to come on board, that's why we move towards a practical exam. So when we move towards a practical exam, there's no need to have coursework assessment or assessor course for the markers, because the practical paper will be marked by Cambridge. Then more schools should be able to come on board. So this is one way we hope to encourage more schools to come on board. Okay, the practical paper, nothing is finalized yet, okay? But in the practical paper, they will have to do programming. See? It's a hands-on. So they will have to debug a program and then give a corrected version. They will have to write a program and they will have to refine the program. So all this will be hands-on, right? The first two, the refinement and debugging, the codes might be provided, but the last one, they have to solve the problem. So hopefully, again, more schools will be encouraged to come on board, because then it doesn't make it very daunting to sit for this practical exam. Yeah? We also do not want to kind of have a disadvantage between an O-level computing student and, let's say, an O-level other subject student. Then they may find that the other subject is easier to pass or to score, and they will not want to take our subject. So we are very careful to make sure that we are on par. Okay? Yes.
For KTW technology, we are currently IDA mentor, providing research for the fund. So, we want to know as IDA mentor, going forward, after 2016, what will be our role in this field?
Okay. Currently IDA is providing the support to schools by getting licensed vendors to go to schools to conduct the program. I think there is still some opportunity from 2016 to 2020 to continue offering your expertise in some schools. Although, because our target is that we hope teachers will be able to teach the program, but again, that depends on individuals, right? So we just hope that at least 50% of the schools, the teachers are ready. So I still see you have a 50% chance. Okay, any other questions? Yes.
What training is done with NIE for computer speaking?
Okay. Currently, NIE is the institution to train our teachers and prepare them for a teaching career. Right? So the general training, they have a general area where they talk about pedagogical skills and assessment. They do not train in terms of content. Okay? So currently, there isn't any training for O-level H2 computing teachers. That means there are no training for these group of people, but there is training for the computer applications teacher. So they will train the teachers on how they should be teaching low ability students. So we are trying to get NIE to come up with the training for all and A level teachers so that they can be prepared to teach this group of students, the pedagogy, the kind of assessment that, or the classroom management and things like that. Yeah.
Sorry, you about that application, right? So it based more towards the programming side, because from then on most of the technical students are IT who respond to technical institutions regarding IT around companies. So will it be more towards on site related for technical and computer applications or not technical fields?
Yeah, okay. For computer applications, we actually will be doing a review. We are doing a midterm review this year, and then probably a full term will come soon in 2 years' time. The idea is, because of the baseline
In Singapore, we also have baseline ICT skills being implemented in schools. So the students should learn a set of baseline ICT skills. And the computer application students are not excluded. So in time to come, things like PowerPoint should not be very difficult to cope. And so we may remove PowerPoint and then put in more computer science stuff. But having said that, it may not be more programming, but it could be hardware related. Right? So we will want our students, these low mobility students, to have a skill. So probably this is the only subject where we can say we can actually prepare students for a career. Okay? They could be our IT support people, right? Because they can do it. So they can also go into network security or simple troubleshooting, they can do that. So we may be looking into these areas for them. Rather than just a mere IT user to type a Word document, which they may not be very good at because of their language ability. Okay, right, thank you very much.